Hello everyone, today we will spend time getting to know scenes in Saola Animate. Scenes in Saola Animate basically act like slides in Microsoft PowerPoint. A document can contain multiple scenes to better divide and arrange content. A scene contains its own set of elements and timelines that is separate from other scenes. You can use events and actions to navigate between scenes. Scenes are shown in the Scenes pane. Commands for managing scenes are accessible from the toolbar as a set of buttons here, or from the Scene menu on the main menu, or from the Scene context menu. So you can see that you can insert, duplicate, cut, copy, paste, and delete scenes. Note that you can edit multiple scenes at once by selecting each one you like while holding down the Control key. Besides, scenes can also be copied and pasted between multiple documents. In that case, all resources and user-defined functions used in these scenes will be copied too. Now we've moved on to the next point, that is about scene properties. Take a look at the Properties pane. You can see that scenes have several properties that are somewhat similar to those of elements. So I think we can skip the usual properties and spend more time on those that are unique to scenes. For the scene size, it can be a fixed value as in pixels, or relative to the container size as in percents. Keep in mind that the container here is a parent element. It can be the browser window if the document is a standalone web page. If not, the parent element can be a div element in which the document is embedded. More details about this will be saved for another tutorial on the flexible layout feature. The next thing to mention is the Auto Advanced property. By default, this property is turned on to make the document playback automatically in order. That is, when the playhead reaches the end of a scene, it will jump to the next one. You can turn Auto Advanced off, then use events and actions to control the flow of your animations. Now I want to focus on one unique property of scenes, the transition effects. Transition effects are movements from one scene to another. The default effect is none, meaning that the scene simply goes away and the next one appears. Currently, Saola Animate supports two alternatives, which are fade and push. This is a fade, and this one is a push. You can fine-tune the effects by specifying the duration in milliseconds and the timing function, or we can call it easing. For the direction attribute, it works only with a push, so you can push a scene from left, top, right, or bottom. So that's some basic understanding of scenes in Saola Animate. Bye for now.